went through a party in the county jail. The prison band was there, they began to wail. The band was jumping and the joint began to swing. You should have heard the knocked out jailbird sing. Let it rock, everybody let it rock. Everybody in the whole cell block was dancing to the tail out rock. Spider Murphy played his inner saxophone.
Hey everybody, it's me BB, and welcome to another awesome edition of BB Cooks. Today, we're going to be making some eggplant Bayou Teche. Now, the Bayou Teche is an important waterway that runs 125 miles through Louisiana. That's a big waterway. This episode, we'll be taking a wild trip to Cajun country. This is DB Cook's Cajun. Now, with Cajun style cooking, it's all about three things. The spice, the sauce, and the roux. We're gonna start with the spices. Everybody thinks Cajun is blow your mouth off hot, and it does have some heat, but it's flavorful heat. So here's the spices you'll need. Just mix them up in the bowl. You need some salt. You need some paprika. Some white pepper. Some onion powder. Some garlic powder, some cayenne pepper, some black peppercorns, some thyme, and some basil. So you'll need about a tablespoon of each of the spices that I have mentioned. So we're gonna add the onion powder. We already added the garlic powder off camera. And we're gonna add some chili pepper. That's to give it some extra spice and extra flavor. You don't wanna add too much of the chili pepper though. So that should be good enough. You wanna add about 2 tablespoons of paprika. I'm gonna do 1/2 tablespoon of the cayenne. Just like that. Now for the basil. It's time to add some thyme. Now we're gonna use our massive monster whiz, baby! Yeah! I gotta combine all of the spices. Spice mix is gonna run all the way through the dish. It's gonna run through the aromatics, it's gonna run through the seafood, and it can even run through the Boston Marathon. Send a special shout out to all of you that are working at the Marshfield Farmers Market. Marshfield Farmers Market is open now, and it does have curbside pickup. They are open usually from October through May, and you can check out their website. That's marshfieldfair.org/farmers-market for more information. Now we're on to the stock part. What you need is a good stock pan, and put it on your oven, and bring the temperature up to medium. Then you want to add a little bit of olive oil.
So here are the vegetables that we're gonna work with. We have some celery, some onions, some carrots, and some garlic. Now you wanna carefully add in each of your vegetables. And what we're gonna do with this Cajun mole is that we're gonna try and get a char to them, which is really, really good for this Cajun mole.
It out right.
So we didn't do that much with the garlic. We're just gonna chuck it right in, just like that. And you can keep the skin on too if you want. Gonna add flavor to this Cajun mole. Now what you need to do is stir it. Just stir it for a little while and stir it gently. Thank you again to the Marshfield Farmers Market for providing this little palm full of our herbs to blend. So we're gonna put it right into our mole. After a spicy meal, you should definitely reach for something sweet for dessert, like I did with this peanut butter cup cupcake, available at Brothers Marketplace on Depot Street in Duxbury. Now we want to add some of our spice mix to the mole. But before we do that, I gotta mention that this is my mom's second favorite dish. You cook this all day and you will make her a very happy gal. Then you want to add about a tablespoon of the spice mixture in with your vegetables. We're gonna add a Calabrian chili pepper from Italy. It'll still give you your spiciness, but not that blow the tongue off your mouth kind of spiciness. And off camera, we decided to add some shrimp shells to this. And you can also mix it in with lobster shells or clam shells too, to make it even more seafoody. Next, we're gonna add about 4 cups of seafood broth. Seafood stock. What you want to do is you want to bring this up to a boil. Then you want to let it go at medium heat until dinner time. And we'll show you how everything comes together later on in today's episode. Here's a look at our eggplant, which we've already cut into 1-inch thick pieces. Then we had it in a bread station and breaded it. We added some spices to it, and we fried it. Now, for those of you that don't really like eggplant, you can definitely do an alternative with this dish. You could do shellfish, you could do maybe even beef if you like that. But today, though, I'm going to be having some chicken. Oh, you're turning it the wrong way. So, we brought our mole up to a boil, and that reduces it by a third. Look at all of this goodness. Today's featured product is Bhotan rice, the U.S.'s number one extra fancy rice. A great compliment to any meal. Available at Shaw's, Star Market, Brothers Marketplace, and many other fine grocery stores. Now we're gonna build our roux. Not our ganga, just our roux. First, you need about a quarter cup of oil. We're using canola oil in this episode. To make your roux, you want to use equal parts of oil and flour. Now, you do need to keep stirring this. But while you do that, you can add a heaping helping of the spice mixture that we made earlier. So, next you want to add a little bit of stock, and that'll get this sauce smoky! Not quite GGD, but that's the brown that we're looking for here in this dish. We're gonna prepare our shrimp. And what you need to do first is add almost a half a stick of butter to a pan, just like this. Then once that starts to get all melted, you want to add another tablespoon of your spice mix. And whisk it up, baby! Now you want to add your shrimp, just like we did. But you want to cook it really quick because this shrimp is fast food! Now we're on to the crab part, and you can use real crab if you want. What you need to do is add on a smaller pan, you need to add 2 tablespoons of butter, the crab, and another heaping tablespoon of the spice mixture that we made earlier. Let the butter melt, add the crab, and let it cook. And don't forget to whisk it too. We have our chicken and eggplant cooking in the oven. Here's what the shrimp looks like. There's our spicy yet delectable sauce. And there's the crab. And we also have some rice too to go on the side. And this is what the finished product looks like. And that's our trip out to Cajun country, Louisiana, right here on DB Cooks. And I just wanted to say a special shout out to all of the nurses working at Gillette Stadium for the vaccination site there. I was able to get the first of my 2 vaccination shots at the Gillette Stadium. And they were pretty cool though about it. So definitely shout outs to you if you are a nurse working at the Gillette Stadium site. And that's gonna do it from me. I'm DB, and I'll catch y'all next time. See you later! Today's featured product is Botox rice.
No.